Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, The ENT Resident. Today I'll be discussing about the differences between two different techniques of mastoidectomy, and that is inside-out mastoidectomy versus outside-in mastoidectomy. This is a topic that is very difficult to understand as postgraduates. I'll try to make it easy and explain over here. You can also now purchase my notes. I have added links in the description. Okay, so let's get started. Starting with, what exactly is inside-out mastoidectomy? Now, inside-out mastoidectomy is actually a fairly new technique compared to outside-in mastoidectomy, which is a more traditional technique. So, what we do is in inside-out mastoidectomy, as the name suggests, we start from the inside and then we progressively go towards the outside. Here, inside means we start this mastoidectomy from the middle ear or the attic region and then slowly work outwards towards the mastoid antrum and the air cell system. So our approach here is very different compared to the traditional technique, which is outside in mastoidectomy, where usually we start drilling from the mastoid cortex. So we start from the outside and then we slowly work inwards towards the antrum, aratus and middle ear. So that is the primary difference over here between inside-out mastoidectomy and outside-in mastoidectomy. Inside-out mastoidectomy is a newer technique, and for this, experienced surgeon is required. And this is a much more difficult technique for somebody who's just beginning out with the surgery. Next, let's look at the steps of the surgery. So if we had to just summarize the steps, for inside-out mastoidectomy, we'll start from the middle ear. So our first step over here would be to elevate the tympanometal flap and gain access to the middle ear and attic. Once we reach the attic, we'll perform an atticotomy and we'll remove the scutum. We'll clear all of the attic disease and then from the attic, progress towards the aditus and then the antrum and then all the mastoid cells from within. So it is important to see here that because we are approaching it from within outwards, in this case, we do very limited cell clearance. We do not remove all of the accessible mastoid air cells like we do in the traditional technique. So here we have started from the middle ear, gone to the attic, then to the aditus, then to the antrum, and then lastly towards all the mastoid cells. Whereas in outside-in mastoidectomy, which is the more traditional mastoidectomy, here we start with a post-auricular incision and exposing the mastoid cortex. That is our first step. So, and then we start drilling through the mastoid cortex and progressively exenterate all mastoid air cells, ultimately reach the antrum. Once we have reached the antrum, then our next step is to move towards the aditus and attic, which we widen up, and then proceed to disease clearance and lastly, tympanoplasty. So you can see how the sequence is completely opposite over here. In inside-out mastoidectomy, we started from the middle ear and attic, going to aditus, antrum, and lastly, the mastoid. Whereas in outside-in mastoidectomy, we start from the mastoid cortex, go to antrum, then reach the aditus, then attic, and lastly, the middle ear. So our sequence is completely opposite over here. Next point is inside-out mastoidectomy is actually a very selective mastoidectomy because in here, we only remove the diseased cells. We do not remove all the normal mastoid cells that we encounter as well. Whereas for outside-in mastoidectomy, it is a wider clearance because we exenterate most of the mastoid cells that we encounter. So there is a difference over here in the extent of the mastoid cell clearance happening over here. Next, let's try to understand, okay, so this is what inside-out mastoidectomy is. So what would be the indications? In which cases would we prefer to choose an inside-out mastoidectomy over the traditional mastoidectomy? So that some indications would be if there is only an attic cholesteatoma. If the disease is limited to the attic, inside-out approach is actually the best approach to go through. Unnecessarily, we won't be going out from outside the from the mastoid cortex like in traditional mastoidectomy. This is actually the most common indication of inside-out mastoidectomy. Second is in cases of limited pediatric cholesteatoma. Why is this the case? Because in pediatric cholesteatoma, usually, most commonly, it has been seen that the disease begins in the epitympanum or the attic region. So again, attic clearance comes first over here. So that's why inside-out mastoidectomy makes more sense. And third, in cases of combined approach tympanoplasty, also this would be an indication to perform inside-out mastoidectomy. Next, looking at outside-in mastoidectomy, it is usually the traditional indications, but more important to remember, if there is disease primarily involving the mastoid, in that case, we will start from the mastoid and then go inwards. So traditional mastoidectomy would make more sense in cases like acute mastoiditis or in cases of chronic otitis media where there is diffuse mastoid involvement. So that's about the indications of both techniques. Coming to skill level, as I have mentioned before, inside-out mastoidectomy is a much newer technique. So usually a skilled surgeon is required. You need more expertise in performing this surgery. Whereas traditional mastoidectomy is actually beginners for a surgeon who's just starting out, it is easier for them to be doing outside-in mastoidectomy because it follows a sequence. It follows certain landmarks. So it has a more laid out systematic approach rather than inside-out mastoidectomy, which needs more expertise to perform. Next, let's look at what are the advantages and disadvantages of inside-out and outside-in mastoidectomy. Starting with inside-out mastoidectomy, I have mentioned that the first advantage here would be targeted clearance. So we are removing only the diseased cells and we are sparing any healthy mastoid. So that's our first advantage. Second is, if the surgeon is experienced, this will actually involve a shorter operating time because you're not going to remove all of the other normal mastoid air cells as well. So this includes a shorter operating time. Third advantage is there is less bone removal over here. Therefore, there is a smaller cavity formation in these cases. And lastly, this is also preferred in pediatric cholesteatoma because in pediatric cholesteatoma, disease usually originates in the attic region. Next, looking at the disadvantages of inside-out mastoidectomy, I have already mentioned this requires a high surgical skill and detailed anatomical knowledge. Second, the risk of residual disease may be higher over here in the deep recesses, like the retrofacial cells or the tip cells or sinodural cells. And third, landmarks may not be encountered in the stepwise manner that we usually do in the traditional mastoidectomy. Next, let's look at the advantages and disadvantages of outside-in mastoidectomy or the more traditional technique of mastoidectomy. Coming to advantages, the first advantage is this is very landmark-based and systematic. So it is actually easier for beginners to begin with this surgery. Second, this ensures a very wide exposure of mastoid air cells. So the chances of recurrence or residual cholesteatoma is lesser over here. Third, it is useful in acute mastoiditis or when mastoid landmarks are intact. Lastly, looking at the disadvantages, disadvantage of this is that this is more time consuming because you are removing many normal cells over here as well. Second is, we may end up over drilling unnecessarily where it is not required because there's no pathology over there. And thirdly, this is less efficient when the disease is mainly in the middle ear or attic. In those cases, it would be preferable to approach through the inside-out mastoidectomy route. So that's all about the differences between inside-out and outside-in mastoidectomy. If you have any further questions on this, please note them down in the comment section and I'll get back to you.